Bamidbar, the Book of Numbers. The Book of Numbers is called Numbers, which actually derives from its midrashic name, Sefer Pikudim, the Book of the Countings, or the Censuses, because there are two censuses which are taken, number counts of the Jewish people, each of the tribes in line. And the Book of Numbers opens with the very first census. I would like to spend a few moments with you about something very curious about the census. If you ask any Jew on the street, what is the Jewish age of majority? You don't even have to be too knowledgeable to respond. 13 years of age for boys, that's when the bar mitzvah celebration takes place, which means son of commandment. And 12 for girls, for young women, bat mitzvah, daughter of commandment. So the age is 20. And here in the census, likewise, everyone is counted, beginning with those who are 20 and above. 20 is the age of conscription to the army. 20 is the age to count for the census. Now, if 20 is the age for conscription and census, how come bar mitzvah is at age 13 and 12? And let me try to explain. There are actually two ages of majority within Judaism. And once again, according to the Midrash, 13 and 12 is the age of majority for this world and this worldly court. Because a young man at age 13, a young woman at age 12 can often parent a child. Individuals who are already developing, sexually growing, must be responsible for their actions. Certainly they must share in the parental responsibility. They have to begin controlling their desires and controlling themselves. But that's only part of the picture. Because when the individual is in his, her teens, until age 20, the individual is usually still tied to his, her parents' home. And when a parent makes a blessing on the Sabbath of the Bar Mitzvah, Baruch Sheptorani Me'onsho Shalazeh, give thanks to God who has freed me, the parent says, from the punishment for this individual, the truth is that until age 13, the parent was solely responsible for his son's activity. Until age 12 of the daughter, the parent is solely responsible for the daughter's transgression. From age 12, 13 to age 20, the shared responsibility continues. From age 20, which is usually when the child leaves the parental home and becomes truly independent, then the child is responsible 100% for his, her own actions or inactions. So that, in effect, there's the age of 12 and 13, which is the first stage of what I would call shared responsibility, and age 20, which is truly independence and sole responsibility of the son, daughter, for their own actions. We have a hint of this when the Bible describes the years of Mother Sarah at her death. 100 years and 20 years and 7 years. Why not 127? Why 100 years, 20 years, 7 years? It seems a bit awkward. Verbose. The Midrash says, cited by Rashi, at age 100, she was just like age 20, free from sin. Because in the higher heavenly court, one is only responsible for sin at age 20. And then, at age 127, she was just like 7 in terms of her very clean and pristine and pure beauty. But we see from this charming midrash that true responsibility, full responsibility for one's actions, is only at age 20 when one becomes independent from one's family setting completely. But only add one more point. This means that Jewish education dare not stop at age 12 and 13. This would mean that Bar Mitzvah is the beginning of the time when a person must study Judaism. Because the truth is that until one's Bar Mitzvah, Bat Mitzvah, the most that one can derive is a kind of picture of Mother Goose Judaism, not a real lifestyle, not a theology and a philosophy. And I've often maintained that there should be 2 Bar Mitzvah, Bat Mitzvah celebrations, one at age 13 and the other at age 20, perhaps in front of the Kotel, in front of the Western Wall of the Holy Temple, perhaps with a special certificate from the President of Israel. And a banner year of preparation for this should take place in Israel. But I think there are many, many ways to go from this notion of 2 majority ages, the most important being that we all understand that 13 and 12 are not the end-all and the be-all of one's Jewish religious education. Okay.